What's up, folks? Nate Vincent here with FCPRO, and I have some engine parts on the table, and we're gonna be looking into these and talking about the tips and tricks to make sure you don't need to take your engine apart twice. So it's pretty common knowledge when you dig into any deep engine repair, you're probably going to be replacing most of the seals and gaskets to get there. You're going to replace your main seals or your head gasket or whatever it may be. But you do have to make sure that the engine parts themselves, the components that are actually being sealed up against, are ready to seal again. There's often times where you can actually replace a seal, but the engine components are worn out and not going to seal up again. Right here, we have a Volvo five-cylinder turbo engine. This is commonly known for having some significant PCV issues. When this PCV fails, or this little diaphragm in this PCV fails, it actually creates a massive amount of crankcase vacuum. Now, you might ask, how does that crankcase vacuum have anything to do with these hard parts here? Well, what happens is that creates a lot of pull-in on the seals around the engine. So in particular, your main seals, your cam seals, they're all going to get pulled into the metal, and is actually going to create a significant amount more friction on that metal when you have high vacuum than you would normally. That friction that you're going to see there is actually going to create a groove within that metal. And I can show you right here with these cam gears, if we were to go reinstall these cam gears with new cam seals, we're gonna see the same exact oil leak within a couple of weeks that we're trying to solve by changing those cam seals in the first place. So what I really wanna do is show you exactly how we're going to identify that. And this is gonna go for any of your sealing surfaces on your engine. So if we're looking at camshafts on a timing belt driven engine, you're gonna look at rear main seal or also your front main seal. These are the places where you're going to have a rubber seal that's going to have a rotating metal object in the middle and trying to keep oil from coming out. Now, on these cam seals you'll see here, there's actually a significant groove. I can catch my fingernail on it. And really with that groove, no matter what seal, whether it's brand new or old, is going to be put on there, it's going to get torn up and the oil is going to work its way through that groove and out where you don't want it to go. Now, if you look at the backside of this cam gear, you can see this is pretty wet with oil because this was actually already leaking. So what I want to do is compare that to this brand new shuffler ENA part right here and show you how smooth this surface is. Now, this is a surface that is ready to be sealed back up again. So if we're going to install new seals on the engine, install a new timing gear on the engine, we're going to have a good sealing surface. Now, whereas if I was to take this old one and we're going to install it, we're going to have a leak. Now, one way you can really identify that leak is by taking either a razor blade or a straight edge and just running it across there. If I run it across, I can see it move smoothly across and then it catches right there. And you see I can flex the straight edge. It's actually catching that groove. There's about a, I would say, a half a millimeter groove on this surface. So that is going to actually, when it starts to rotate, that's actually going to tear up the seal and basically make the seal useless again. Now you may ask, what are your options? I can't go replace my crankshaft if I have a little bit of a groove in it. That's right. So there's options and there's times where it makes sense to actually go take those parts and have them ground or machined back smooth again. There's usually a tolerance for that, how much you can take off that surface to allow it to seal back up. But there's also times where it is just simpler, easier, and more cost effective to replace the parts. And that is the case with these cam gears, where these are available and in stock at fspro.com. And they're actually a very easy item to replace. And you just basically take this one off and you put this one on and you replace it with a brand new seal and you'll stop any oil leaks in the future on your engine. All right, so one tip I will always say, especially when we're replacing the parts like these cam gears here on this Volvo T5, is make sure you save the old cam gears. Now you can see the timing belt has been replaced on this car a couple times. There are some really helpful marks that are on here, like right here, this little white mark. Now you're gonna wanna make sure you save the old ones and transfer any marks over to the new ones to make sure you have those extra reference points when you're retiming and reinstalling these parts on the engine. If you have a significant vacuum on the engine, you can tell by taking the oil cap off, or you'll hear kind of like a almost like a sucking or a growling noise coming from the engine of your Volvo T5. Do not drive it too much. We actually recommend you don't drive the car at all. That reason is basically that seal is getting pulled into your camshafts and into your main seals as that car is pulling too much vacuum on that crankcase. And every time that engine rotates, you're adding a little bit more wear. So if you want to avoid having to replace these parts, we suggest not starting the engine, not running it at all. Now, if you are absolutely stranded and need to drive the car a little bit, there's a couple things you can do. You can actually pull the dipstick out of the dipstick hole a little bit, allow air to go down the dipstick in the crankcase to alleviate some of that vacuum. That is should only be done just a teeny bit. That's really not a tip I would suggest driving more than 15 or 10 minutes doing. So if you do find that your car is starting up making a growling noise, we do have a DIY on how to replace this entire PCV unit right here. That is for the Volvo T5 engine or any of the turbo five cylinder Volvo engines. And just to let you know, the parts that you get from fspiro.com are actually the updated parts. So this was a known issue with Volvo. They've made some revisions and changes to this part. So the part that you will be putting on your car is probably better than the part you took off. But definitely this alleviates the problem. It will make sure you don't pull a massive vacuum on the engine. It will also make sure that your seals stay good. But if the engine went too long and you do need to replace the cam gears, obviously we have you covered here with these ENA cam gears to make sure you can seal your engine back up, replace your timing belt, and get back on the road. Now, if you have any questions about the PCV DIY, we'll add a link below that will go over exactly what you need to do to replace the PCV system so you don't pull those crazy vacuums and you don't ruin the seals on your engine. Well, we spoke mostly about the Volvo turbo five cylinder engine here, as that is the case of the parts that we have right in front of us and the issue that we're dealing with. This goes for any rotating seal in the engine. And really my best advice for you is whether it's a crankshaft or a camshaft is just to make sure you check those parts before you reinstall new seals and reinstall those parts in your car so you don't have to take your engine apart twice and deal with the mess all over again. So just real quick, talking about the products here, obviously you can see our two cam gears, we have them matched up with the old cam gears. They're exactly the same. Scheffler and ENA brand is actually OE on Volvo. So these are the original equipment. So they are actually the company that provided Volvo with the cam gears when Volvo first made these engines. So you see their exact fitment, exactly the same. All their tolerances are the same. Really great part. Also, like I said, available at fspiro.com. We're talking about the seal a little bit. We have a seal here. You can see that the front leading edge of the seal is basically like a windshield wiper. And imagine as your windshield wipers wear out, as they get dull, a little bit more residue is left over them. That's exactly how an oil seal on an engine like this works. And so that front edge needs to stay undamaged. So there's a couple things you really need to be careful about. A, you wanna make sure there's lubrication on both the part and the seal when you go to install it. And if you see, if I were to install this on this old one, as soon as this starts to rotate and this groove here starts to go around here, it's gonna start to cut this seal and make it less effective. Probably week, maybe 2 weeks later, it'll be leaking oil just as bad as the original seals in the car were leaking oil. Now, looking at the new part, you can see how smooth that cylinder is that this seal is going to seal up against. And as I push it on, you can actually see it slowly deform the seal, just like a wiper blade on a car. And as I rotate it down, you can see it actually seals up and creates that seal. Now, if there's a groove there, or if there was some sort of dirt or whatever on this, that's not going to seal up. So this is very critical when putting your engines back together that you make sure you lubricate the parts and you make sure that the bores or the cylinders that are sealing up are extremely smooth and ready to accept that seal. All right, everyone, if you found this video helpful, please give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions at all, leave them in the comments below. And if you like content like this and want to see more of it, please subscribe to our channel. We'll catch you on the next one.